Hey there, welcome to yet another Flutter Mentor tutorial. Today we're gonna figure out how to pass data between pages, either when you go forward in the page or backward in the page. When we pop, we're going backward. When we push, we're going forward. That's essentially it. And we're also going to see how to pass data forward using named routes. If you wanna learn about this, then stick around and find out. So let's just get straight into it. I'm just going to go ahead and just explain really quickly what's going on here. There's a map right here, but I'll get into that later. Right now, just focus on these two strings, which are going to be what we're going to submit when we submit the name and the age. And then you have this bool is adult, which is just to define this sentence right here. It will either say you are an adult or you are underaged. The point of this is just for when we go to this next page, once we go back, we will figure out based on the age if it's an adult or not, and then we will send that data back here and the sentence will be affected according to that value. The UI is super simple, just two text fields, a size box, and a button. Screen 2 is pretty much the same. There's these two variables which will be used to replace this text right here. As you can see, right now it's the variable or your name, and same, if it's null, then you just say your age. If it's not null, then we represent the age right there. Pretty simple basic stuff. Right here is a Navigator.pop, etc. So let's just get the first method out of the way, which is the simplest one. It's already right here. Navigator.push. So as you saw, basically screen 2 has these two variables which it expects on its constructor, and all we have to do really is provide them. We just say name, which is one of the properties, okay, and then we use this variable right here, the variable name, and we send this information over, and of course we do the same with the age. This is literally all that it takes. You know, you just use navigator.push, and if you don't know how to navigate across the pages, you can click the video on the top right. But other than that, you just use the constructor as you normally would. And then let me come back here. If I do Joseph and I give him 20 years old and submit, there is Joseph 20 years old. As simple as that. Now, how can we make it so that when we return, this sentence is affected by the age? Right now it's underage, but like you saw, I put in 20 years old and it still says you are underage. That's not what we want. If it's an adult, we want this to change. So the way we do that is instead of doing the regular Navigator push, first we've got to turn this into an async function, because we're going to be dealing with futures. Basically, you're going to submit to the next screen, and this line of code right here will be awaiting the data that you will receive once you pop on this page. So what we're going to do is we're going to create a new variable. We're going to call it bool data. You can call it whatever you want, and we're going to say equals this, but we're going to await. And this is the key here, because we're going to await the pop to happen in order to get the data. And once we do get the data, all we gotta do is use setState to make sure that the text is updated. And then we just go to isAdult is equal to bool data. That's everything you need to do on this page. Then all you got to do in screen 2, as you can see, there's already a different bool called isAdult. All you would have to do is come over here and first let's check if it's an adult. Basically, we're just gonna go widget.age. If it's bigger or equal than 18, then we want to make isAdult equals to true. Else, we want to make isAdult equals to false. This is a ternary expression. If you don't understand it, search ternary operator and you'll figure out very quickly. It's really simple. Basically, if this is true, do this. If it's not, then do this. It's as simple as that. So when you press, this is going to run, and then you want to pass the value of isAdult. So going back, just to make sure you understand, we're getting that information into this variable right here, all because we are awaiting the navigator.push. So when we pop, this will actually return data over here. I'm going to restart the app. Let's do the same thing again. Let's just call him Joe this time, 24 years old. And remember that this text right here is what's going to change. I'm going to submit. It's Joe, it's 24. And when we go back, you are an adult. As you can see, the data traveled when we popped the stack. This will work with a string, an int, etc. Whatever the data was that we sent, it will be right here and you could use it. Now for the other example, we're gonna pass data through named routes. So first up, let's set it up real quick. Once again, you can click the same video as before to learn more about named routes. Okay, here we go. The routes have been set up. So now all I gotta do is actually work with them. So let me just get rid of this real quick. Instead of .push, we want to do push named. And then here we just want to say screen 2. And here, if you do Control Q, you can see right here, it takes a build context, a string, and then an object of arguments. This is exactly where I'm going to show off the map. We have this map right here, and the information isn't important at all. Let's just focus on the map itself. It's called data map. So what we do here is after the comma where you specify the screen you want to go, you use a named argument, which is arguments. And Control Q here, and it tells you it expects a type list widget. Don't worry about this, just drop in the data map right here. And then the question would be, how can we access this information? You have to come here on the second screen, and once the build method starts, but before it returns, we need to create a new variable. Let's call it root data. And here you use modal root.ofContext.settings.arguments. And since we're working with a map, you say as map string int, because that's what our map is right here, string and an int. Then you close this off, and now let's access the third entry of the map, number 3. Let's create a variable, call it third key. And what you do is route data and then square brackets. And here you put in the name of the key, which is number 3 right here, like so. And then you close it off. And that's pretty much it. Now you can use this variable. And let's just completely scrap the age. We no longer need it. Let's just do this dot to string. And now I'm going to do hot reload. So now this doesn't really matter at all. I'm going to put in a 1. But nothing will actually cross over because we no longer send that data over. But just to show you that it's not this data that's going to show up, we have a 1 and what shows up is a 3. So this worked. So what we did was we had this map in screen number 1 and we accessed this entry of the map in screen number 2. All because we passed it through the named route, push named, using its arguments property. Now the going back option will not work, of course, because we haven't passed the name or the age arguments here. We just passed the data map. But if you wanted to go back to the previous system where we sent over the name and the age, all you'd have to do is create a map, for example. Basically just do name equals name and age is also age. Going back to the first page by restarting the app, now let's give it a name and let's make it an adult again, 78 years old. Submit to next screen, and that crashed because I forgot to come here, change this because it's no longer string int, but now it's string object because we have a string and an int as well, right here. This is the string and this is the int. And also, this is no longer how we access it. Now we want the new name, let's just call it new name. And instead of this right here, we say name, of course. And if you do Control D, it just copies it over to the next line, like so. And instead of this, do H. And instead of this right here, we just do new name and new H. And now if I restart this, everything should work properly. Do 2e again, 55, submit the next screen, and there you go. And now that I'm gonna hit go back, it doesn't work because there was an error that, once again, I am very distracted. I forgot to change this right here, but if we say new age, it won't work because it's reading this as an object. So I'm just gonna do final new age int equals new age. And then all I gotta do is come here and change this. And it still doesn't work, but what you gotta do is do int. And now it finally works. I'm gonna restart this. And for the last time, we're gonna see it say, you are an adult. I hope this helped you. If anything at all is confusing, feel free to just ask me about it in the comments. And I'll do my best to clear it up. Thank you for watching. I hope you did learn something. If you did, don't forget to drop me a like. And if you want to keep on learning more and more and more about Flutter, hit that subscribe button. Once again, thank you for watching. This is Flutter Mentor, and out.